Good morning, I am Shashi Karun and welcome to Online Learning Programming in C++. Today, I will discuss about the generation of computer. What were the technology that were used in earlier and now generation? So let's start with the topic. After going this presentation, you will be able to know about the technology that was used in different generation of the computer. You will also able to explain the different features of the different generation of computer. So computer generation means what are the development has been taken place in computer technology. Nowadays computer is much more better than the computer which was used earlier. So there are five generation of the computer. The first generation of computer time period is 1940 to 1956 and the hardware technology used was vacuum tube. In second generation, the time period was from 1956 to 1963 and the hardware technology used was transistor. In case of third generation, the time period was between 1963 to 1971 and the hardware technology used was integrated circuit. In the fourth generation, the time period was from 1971 to 1980. And the hardware technology used was microprocessor. And in the fifth generation, the time period was from 1918 to till date. And the hardware technology using are integrated circuit with ultra large scale integration. So today in this session, we will discuss about the various technology and what are the features in different generation of the computer. So you can see that on the screen, there are different type of generation. That is first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation, and fifth generation. If you see the first generation computer, then you can find that it is a very big computer which can occupy a very large space. Whereas in case of fifth generation, the computer size is small and it occupies less space as compared to the previous generation. So these are the different computers of different generation. So in the first generation, you can see that the hardware technology was vacuum tube. You can see the picture of the vacuum tube. After that, in the second generation, the transistor is used. In the third generation, it is integrated circuit. And in fourth generation, it is microprocessor. In the fifth generation, it is integrated circuit with ULSI, that is ultra large scale integration. There are different type of integration, that is SSI, small scale integration, medium scale integration, large scale integration, very large scale integration, ultra large scale integration. Now there are giga scale integration. So what is this integration? In this different technology, number of transistor is different in different integration. Like in small scale integration, the number of transistor will be less, but in case of ultra large scale integration, the transistor component will be more. So let us discuss the first generation of the computer. What are the features in the first generation? The features in the first generation is that the technology used was vacuum tube and punch card. Punch card is something like a tape, paper tape, or it is a card where there is a hole. So that is used for input or output purpose. Then in the first generation, the machine language is used, that is machine language is used to do programming. And the first generation computer was slow in performance because the speed of CPU is high as compared to the speed of the input output devices. पहले क्या करते थे, punch card के through हम क्या करते थे, computer में feed करते थे ताकि computer को पता चले कि क्या क्या काम करना है. तो वो जो हम input device से हम क्या करते थे, punch card insert करते थे, तब तक जो सीपीयू था वो उतना यूटिलाइज नहीं होता था. सीपीयू वाज स्टेइंग आइडल बिकॉज द स्पीड ऑफ सीपीयू इज हाई एज कंपेयर टू द स्पीड ऑफ द मैकेनिकल और इनपुट आउटपुट डिवाइसेज. सो इट वाज स्लो इन परफॉर्मेंस. नेक्स्ट, द कंप्यूटर वाज लार्ज इन साइज. यस, यू हैव ऑलरेडी सीन दैट द देयर वाज अ बिग कंप्यूटर. सो इट वाज वेरी एक्सपेंसिव, इट ऑक्युपाई वेरी लार्ज स्पेस. सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज वेरी कॉस्टली एट दैट टाइम. then it is unreliable and poor storage capacity. Yes, the computer was unreliable because it consumed a lot of electricity. जो पहले के कंप्यूटर थे वो क्या करते थे, सबसे पहले एक तो आपके इलेक्ट्रिसिटी को ज़्यादा कंज्यूम करते थे, दूसरा उसमें हीट प्रोडक्शन ज़्यादा होती थी जिसके कारण उसमें टेक्निकल इशू आ जाते थे. तो ड्यू टू दैट रीजन इट इज अनरिलायबल एंड देयर इज ए पुअर स्टोरेज कैपेसिटी. दैट टाइम द स्टोरेज वॉज यूज पंच कार्ड में ही आप स्टोरेज का यूज करते. नाउ डेज वी हैव टू यूज इन स्टोरेज लाइक पेन ड्राइव, हार्ड डिस्क, एक्सटर्नल हार्ड डिस्क. So, which is a reliable, which is having a high storage capacity as compared to the first generation computer. उस टाइम आप मैग्नेटिक टेप भी देखा होगा आपने, तो उसमें क्या होती थी, कम स्टोरेज कैपेसिटी होती थी. Then there is a drawbacks of that first generation computer that it consume a lot of electricity. There is a more generation of heat and there is a need of AC, air cooling की सिस्टम की जरूरत होती थी क्योंकि उस टाइम के जो कंप्यूटर थे वो जल्दी हीटअप हो जाते थे. दीज आर सम एग्जाम्पल्स लाइक द फर्स्ट इन केस ऑफ फर्स्ट जनरेशन कंप्यूटर आर ABC एंटोनोसॉफ बेरी कंप्यूटर विच वॉज डेवलप विच वॉज सक्सेसफुली टेस्टेड इन 1942. देन देर वॉज अ कंप्यूटर ENAC इलेक्ट्रॉनिक न्यूमेरिकल इंटीग्रेटेड एंड कंप्यूटर विच वॉज डेवलप इन 1945, समवेयर इट इज रिटन 1946. Then there is EDVAC, that is Electronic Discrete Variable Automatic Computer, which was developed in 1949. Now, according to my research from the Google side, or according to the information available from the Wikipedia, I found that the Konrad Zuse, who was a German civil engineer, who was a pioneer computer scientist, inventor, businessman, he developed the first programmable computer, Z1, between 1936 to 1939. So the first programmable computer developed was Z1. After that he improved the functionality of that machine. Then he developed Z2, Z3, then Z4. Z3 was developed in 1941. So it is a first computer, programmable computer. After that, Dr. John Vincent Antonoff and his graduate student Clifford Berry developed a computer that is known as ABC, which is a first specific purpose digital computer. It is not a general purpose, it is used for specific purpose. It is used for solving the linear equation problem. So it is a specific purpose, but it is not programmable computer. It has limitation. So it is world first specific digital computer. Then John Prosper Eckert and John Mauchly, they were the professor of University of Pennsylvania. They invented a computer that is ENAC, which is a first programmable general purpose digital computer. So this is a first general purpose digital computer which was developed in 1945. And after that, they created many other machines, that is EDVAC, BINAC, that is binary automatic computer, then UNIVAC, that is universal automatic computer, which is developed in 1951, and it was used for commercial purpose also. And then they both started a company which known as Electronic Control Company in 1949. So this is a first computer company which is known as Electronic Control Company. Later on this company name was changed, then it is known as Eckert Mauchly Computer Corporation. So you can see that there is a computer ENAC, and there it is written that it is a world first digital computer. And you can also see that there is a punch card. So this is a punch card where the instruction is given to the computer so that the computer can perform some tasks. Now come to the second generation of the computer. In second generation of computer, the technology used was transistor, and the operating system was batch operating system. I will discuss later on what is this operating system. Then there was the computer which was faster than previous generation, and the computer was smaller in size than the previous generation. जो आपकी सेकेंड जनरेशन थी उसमें जो कंप्यूटर था उसका साइज क्या था, पहले से एक तो कम था और दूसरा वो उससे फास्टर था. Then the second generation computer was reliable, energy efficient than previous generation. प्रीवियस जनरेशन कंप्यूटर थे वो अनरिलायबल थे, क्यों? उसमें टेक्निकल इशू आते थे. मोर मोर कंजम्पशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी वॉज देयर, मोर प्रोडक्शन ऑफ हीट वॉज देयर, ड्यू टू विच देर वॉज अ टेक्निकल इशू. सो दिस कंप्यूटर वॉज रिलायबल एंड एनर्जी एफिशियंट एज कम्पेयर टू द प्रीवियस जनरेशन. नाउ इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्राइस इट इज लेस कॉस्टली देन द प्रीवियस जनरेशन बिकॉज द साइज इज रिड्यूस, सो इट इज लेस कॉस्टली एज कम्पेयर टू द प्रीवियस जनरेशन. Also, it takes less time than the previous generation. The previous generation takes time to process, to execute the job, but in case of second generation, it takes less time. Then, in this generation, the machines support machine language and assembly language. Then, assembly language can be used in this second generation of computer, but in first generation, there was machine language. Sometime there was no operating system was there. So we use machine language. We do programming in punch card, and according to the programming, the computer perform the work. So these are some examples. That is Honeywell 400, CDC 1604, IBM 7030. Now, in third generation, the technology used was IC, that is integrated circuit, which was invented by the Jack Kibble. Jack Kibble is a person who invented this IC chip. He was also awarded with the Nobel Prize for his work. In this generation of computer, there is a multi-programming operating system used, and the computer was faster and smaller than the previous generation. The computer in the third generation are more reliable than previous generation. They were cheaper than previous generation. Why it is cheaper? Because again, the size is reducing. Also, this computer consumed less power and there is a less heat generation as compared to the previous generation. And from this generation, the computer was available for the commercial use for the and it supported high-level language. So you can see that there is a many example of the third generation computer, that is IBM 360, 370, CDC 6600, PDP 8/11. Now come to the fourth generation. In fourth generation, the technology used was microprocessor, which was made by the Intel around 1971. Then the operating system we used was time sharing based operating system. The computer of this generation was cheap and portable. Portable means you can carry from one place to another, जिसे आप आसानी से लेकर जा सके. तो from fourth generation, the PC revolution started. Personal computer revolution started. Then in this generation, the computer was small and easy to use. Then there is a handheld computer which was started to evolve from this generation. In this generation of computer, there is no need of external cooling. There is no need of AC, and this type of computer are affordable. इसमें एसी की जरूरत क्यों होती थी? Because there is a very few heat production and there is a very few consumption of electricity as compared to the previous generation, where there is a lot of consumption of electricity, lot of production of heat. So there at that time AC was required, but in the fourth generation the AC is not required. Then the computer of the fourth generation are more reliable than the previous generation, and they also produce less heat than the previous generation. The generation of this computer support the high level language like C language and other languages, and there was the concept of internet started from this generation. There are some examples of fourth generation computer, that is DEC 10, Cray 1. Cray 1 is a supercomputer that is developed by the American company. Now come to the fifth generation. In fifth generation, the hardware technology used was integrated circuit with ULSI technology. The computer of this generation are powerful, cheap, reliable, and easy to use. Now you can see that you are having desktop or laptop in your home. So it is cheap, you can afford, you can purchase this computer. But earlier it was not easy to purchase that very big size of computer for your general purpose, for your home purpose, or for your business purpose. And that time the computer was not reliable And this time the laptop, desktop are more reliable, they are more easy to use, because today we are having operating system, that is Windows operating system, which are having their graphical user interface. You have to just click on the icon and the application start running. That time there was no graphical user interface, so it is easy to use. Now the current generation computer are portable. Yes, it is portable. You can carry the laptop from one place to another. Then it is faster due to use of parallel processor. Parallel processor means sometimes you have heard the word, that is Core 2 Duo, quad core, octa core. So multiple processor are using. So multiple task is given to the different processor for parallel processing. जैसे अगर मैं अकेला हूँ तो अगर मुझे 10 काम करने हैं तो आई विल टेक 1 by 1 वर्क टू एग्जीक्यूट टू कम्प्लीट दैट वर्क. इफ देयर आर 10 पर्सन, देन 10 वर्क कैन बी असाइन टू 10 पर्सन एंड इट कैन बी एग्जीक्यूटेड एट अ सेम टाइम. सो दिस इज ए पैरेलल प्रोसेसिंग. देन देर इज ए मल्टी प्रोसेसिंग सपोर्ट. मल्टी प्रोसेसिंग सपोर्ट मीन्स मोर देन वन CPU कैन बी देयर इन अ सिस्टम और मोर देन वन प्रोसेसर कैन बी देयर इन अ सिस्टम, सो दैट the parallel processing can be done at the same time. Multiple tasks can be executed at the same time. Then in this current generation of computer, there is a support of high level language, that is C++, Java. In current generation of computer, you can have a language C++, Java. You can implement the program on your laptop, run the program, execute the program. Then there is a point that is more user friendly interface. Yes, the operating system we are using are more user friendly. It is graphical user interface. Earlier there was command based computer system, operating system, that is MS-DOS, where you have to enter the command for creating folder file. But now you can right click on the mouse and you can create or open any file. So it is easy. In this generation of computer, there is a multimedia features. Yes, there is a multimedia features. You can install media player, you can open webcam, you can listen to music, you can watch video. So these are some multimedia features. You can have video conferencing through laptop, you can insert headphones, so that you can communicate with other person. Availability of very powerful and compact computer at cheaper rate. Yes, at affordable, as the computer of current generation is affordable, you can buy the computer at a cheaper price than the previous generation. There are some examples, that is desktop, laptop, ultrabook, Param is a Indian supercomputer. You can also visit website of Param. There you can see that there are multiple series of the Param. So these are all contents of the generation of the computer. Now I have used the word, that is batch processing, time sharing. So what is batch processing? The batch processing means, you can see that earlier there was a user. Suppose there are multiple users, user 1, 2, 3, n number of users. All they want to execute their job. Job means a program plus data. Like today, you can make any program, you can give any data to the computer and it will execute the program and give you the output. That time the user give the job to the operator. That time the operator operate the machine. Then the operator make a batches. वो batch बनाता था, जैसे कि आपका tutorial पहले जो हमारे physical classroom में होते थे तो वहाँ क्या होते थे, tutorial में हम 30-30 बच्चों का group बनाते हैं, तो वैसे ही operator क्या करता है, batch बनाता है. Batch किसका बना रहा है, उन job का जो similar kind के job है. जैसे मान लो कोई हो गया job ये कि print ही करना है कोई भी डॉक्यूमेंट, तो वो एक बैच में हो गया. दूसरा कुछ और काम है तो वो दूसरे बैच में हो गया. अब ये जो CPU वो क्या करेगा, पहले बैच को एग्जीक्यूट करेगा. जब तक पहला बैच के जॉब के एग्जीक्यूट नहीं होगा, तब तक दूसरे बैच के जॉब एग्जीक्यूट नहीं होंगे. सो दिस इज ए बैच प्रोसेसिंग. ऑल द जॉब्स आर ग्रुप इनटू डिफरेंट बैचेज. नाउ इन टाइम शेयरिंग ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, दिस इज ए CPU एंड देयर आर एन नंबर ऑफ प्रोसेस और एन नंबर ऑफ प्रोग्राम. The CPU is switching between the process. पहले CPU process 1 में जाएगा, process 2 में जाएगा, process 3 में जाएगा, process 4 में जाएगा. अब बात ही है कि प्रोसेस क्या है। प्रोसेस मीन्स प्रोग्राम इन एग्जीक्यूशन। सपोज आपने कोई प्रोग्राम बनाया, जब वो एग्जीक्यूशन मोड में होता है तो उसे क्या बोलते हैं हम, प्रोसेस। प्रोग्राम इन एग्जीक्यूशन मोड इज अ प्रोसेस, वेयर एज प्रोग्राम इज अ सेट ऑफ द इंस्ट्रक्शन दैट इज गिवन टू द कंप्यूटर फॉर परफॉर्मिंग सम टास्क। तो दैट इज अ प्रोग्राम। तो आप देखो बैकग्राउंड में काफी प्रोसेस चले होते हैं, कभी आप देखना बीच में टाइमर का प्रोसेस चला होता है, जो आपका क्लॉक है टाइम बताता है वो भी पीछे बैकग्राउंड में चला होता है। तो अब सीपीयू क्या कर रहा है, बारी बारी करके सारे प्रोसेस को एग्जीक्यूट कर रहा है। इन टाइम शेयरिंग सिस्टम, सपोज यू वांट टू लिसन म्यूजिक, यू वांट टू चैट विद द फ्रेंड्स इन फेसबुक, तो वो सीपीयू क्या कर रहा है, प्रोसेस वन में भी जा रहा है, प्रोसेस टू में भी जा रहा है, प्रोसेस थ्री में भी जा रहा है। तो द सीपीयू इज डूइंग स्विचिंग अमंग द प्रोसेस। वो स्विचिंग इतना फास्ट होता है कि आपको पता नहीं लगता। तो इट इज एंटरटेनिंग ऑल द प्रोसेस बाय स्विचिंग, बट इन केस ऑफ बैच प्रोसेसिंग ओनली वन बैच विल बी कंप्लीटेड, आफ्टर दैट नेक्स्ट बैच विल बी कंप्लीटेड। ऑल्सो यू शुड नो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन बैच प्रोसेसिंग एंड मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग। अगर हम बैच प्रोसेसिंग की बात करें तो ये क्या करता है, इट एग्जीक्यूट वन जॉब एट अ टाइम। अगर आप यहाँ पर देखो तो सीपीयू में, तो ये क्या करेगा, पहले एक ही बैच को एग्जीक्यूट करेगा फिर उसके बाद दूसरे बैच को। लेकिन मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग की बात करें तो ये क्या करेगा, एग्जीक्यूट मल्टीपल जॉब। सपोज करो आपके पास 10 प्रोसेस है, तो जो पहला प्रोसेस आया, प्रोसेस मीन्स प्रोग्राम इन एग्जीक्यूशन मोड, तो सीपीयू क्या करेगा, उसको प्रोसेस करेगा। अब उस प्रोसेस को सीपीयू की जरूरत नहीं है, उसे किसी इनपुट आउटपुट डिवाइस की जरूरत है, तो उस केस में सीपीयू क्या करेगा, दूसरे प्रोसेस को एग्जीक्यूट करेगा। अब जो दूसरा प्रोसेस है उसको भी सीपीयू की जरूरत नहीं है, उसको इनपुट आउटपुट की जरूरत है, तो वो क्या करेगा, तीसरे प्रोसेस को एग्जीक्यूट करेगा। तो दिस इज ए मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग। बैच प्रोसेसिंग में क्या होता है, सीपीयू इज आइडल। आइडल क्यों, मान लो यहां पर ऑपरेटर है, ये क्या कर रहा है, बैच में ग्रुप कर रहा है, तो दिस टाइम द सीपीयू इज आइडल, इट इज नॉट हैविंग एनी वर्क, सो इट इज नॉट यूटिलाइजिंग द सीपीयू। बट इन केस ऑफ टाइम शेयरिंग और मल्टी प्रोसेसिंग और मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग सिस्टम, द सीपीयू इज ऑलवेज बिजी। सीपीयू कुछ ना कुछ एग्जीक्यूट कर रहा होता है, ऑलवेज परफॉर्म द टास्क, सो इट इज नॉट आइडल। बट इन केस ऑफ बैच प्रोसेसिंग द सीपीयू मे बी आइडल ड्यू टू स्पीड डिफरेंस। स्पीड डिफरेंस किसका, यहाँ पर देखो ऑपरेटर क्या करेगा, जॉब को इनपुट करेगा, इनपुट कैसे करेगा, पंच कार्ड के थ्रू, सो इट विल टेक अ टाइम एंड दैट टाइम द सीपीयू इज आइडल। वेयर एज इन करंट जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर you can feed the input by using mouse keyboard and the cpu can perform the task. In case of batch processing it is slow, in case of multi programming it is fast. In case of batch processing there is no direct interaction of operating system with the user. aap yahan par dekho, yahan par operator hai, to pehle kya karte hai, user operator ko job dete hai और उसके बाद ऑपरेटर क्या करता है, उसको फीड करता है कंप्यूटर को। सो देयर इज नो डायरेक्ट इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड द यूजर, बट इन केस ऑफ करंट जनरेशन देयर इज अ डायरेक्ट इंटरेक्शन। यू कैन इंटरेक्ट विद द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, यू कैन इंटरेक्ट विद द विंडो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम डायरेक्टली, सो देयर इज अ डायरेक्ट इंटरेक्शन। नाउ इट इज क्लियर। देयर इज अ वन मोर कॉन्सेप्ट, दैट इज मल्टी प्रोसेसिंग। मल्टी प्रोसेसिंग मीन्स मल्टीपल प्रोसेस कैन बी एग्जीक्यूटेड एट अ सेम टाइम। It means there can be multiple processor or there can be multiple CPU within a system. एक system के अंदर multiple CPU भी हो सकते हैं, multiple processor भी हो सकते हैं। उन different processor को हम different task दे सकते हैं ताकि at the same time सारे process क्या हो, एक साथ execute हो जाए। तो that is a multi-processing. So today in this video presentation you have learned that what are the different technology that is used in different generation of computer, what are the different features of different generation of computer. So I hope you have understood the today's topic.